But also from the beginning of time when Jesus came into the world. So we're just following in his footsteps, and we pass it on to you so that you can understand that there is always an unconditional love that a parent has for their son.
I'm here in Brooklyn, and I just witnessed an amazing graduation. Michelle Lee, a Diamond Video. First of all, I want to thank everyone who came out today at the, well, they call it the Ajax Park, and I found out today. In Brooklyn at the amazing Rites of Passage ceremony with the founder of this organization. And your name is?
Horace Moore.
It's so nice to meet you. How are you feeling about the events that just occurred today?
Ecstatic. I'm ecstatic and just honored to have the opportunity to be able to bless the young men and their families.
That's beautiful. I'm honored to have watched this ceremony. I was honestly inspired. So what inspired you to start this organization?
Well, after being in education for 30 years, I realized that so many of our young sons don't get the opportunities to grow and be exposed to various other opportunities. And I saw that the disparity in young women graduating and young men graduating, so I wanted to do something different to be intentionally directed to young men.
That's so beautiful. Yeah, because there's not enough programs for our young black men. And I'm inspired by the fact that you began this organization in the first place. So what is one message that you would like to leave with all of the graduates today?
That they go out and be servants. Be servants to others, be servants to their community and to the world. Be the change agent that we have created in them and instilled in them.
That's absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for interviewing with us today. Thank you so much for your time. And one more thing, I love the foot washing ceremonies. I just wanted to know, what gave you that idea?
One of the things is we model after our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who demonstrated that when he washed his disciples' feet. That was a sign of humility, but also a sign of service. So what we would like the young men to know that their mothers who first washed their feet in the beginning will now wash their feet as they walk into manhood. But it also shows a sign of humility, but more importantly, a sign of service. And that's what we want those young men to walk away with.
Humility and service. What a beautiful message. I love it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Warrior.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
God bless the warriors.
Right on. Power to the people.
Power to the people. Guess what? One more time. We outside.
You prefer, whichever you're more comfortable with.
Here we go. Count it down. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Hey, this is Yannick in Brooklyn, still at the Rites of Passage ceremony. I'm here with.
Hi, I'm Susan Delmore. Oh, I'm with Janusu Bukhari, and I'm the communications director and the parent liaison.
Wow, that's beautiful. I just wanted to thank you so much for allowing us to document this beautiful event. No problem. So, what inspired you to get involved with this organization?
Sure. I got involved about 14 years ago. Actually, I'm a parent. I have a young black man. My son is now 21. He got involved when he was 10, and I was looking for an organization where my son could be connected with other young men and older men that would give him leadership, mentorship, empowerment, get those decision-making skills as well as a strong foundation and how to journey into to be a man.
That is so beautiful. I mean, how could you not love an organization like this? Okay, so family is what drew you to this.
Yes.
This is one of my awesome young men.
ROP got my bees.
Morehouse College, second year, computer science major. I love him.
HBCU, as you should. I'm into Lincoln, so I got to shout out HBCUs. I also wanted to know, okay, so I know you said that your son is a part of this. How do you feel?
Well, my son, actually, he's an alumnus, so he graduated. So, but still seeing the young men, I thought, this is my son. I stayed involved. So once he graduated from the program, I stayed involved and wanted to offer my skills and my talent to help the young men behind him. So the younger young men, so starting from eight years old and older. So I wanted to offer my skills in technology and writing and communications to ensure that this program can continue to grow throughout the years forward.
I absolutely love that. Thank you so much for your time and your dedication to helping the young men in the community. Oh yes, let's hear from your son. Absolutely. And your name is?
My name is Reggie Huggins. I'm an alumni from CB. I graduated in 2018. That was my rites of passage year. I did it twice though, because I'm a little special. But it was not about me. My mother is amazing. She's been really working with them for the longest, really helping them on the technological side, making sure we still advance and moving with the times. And she makes sure Mr. Mora helps everything go smoothly. For me, at least from what I know. Also, I know that she's amazing. And she got me here, so yeah.
Thank you. So the mom is proud of the son, and the son is proud of the mom. I love it. I love it so much. So thank you so much, both, for your time, dedication, and just being amazing. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
All right.
One more thing. What's up? We outside.
I wish you the best in all of your endeavors.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hey, it's Yannick. I'm here with father and son.
Deshaun Thomas.
And?
Elijah Thomas.
Beautiful. Hello, Thomas brothers.
Thanks.
So I just had a few questions. How do each of you feel about the events that just occurred today?
I thought it was an awesome event. The young men did their thing. I'd love to see the growth in the young men as they grow from little. Becoming teenagers now to adulthood. They're doing their thing.
It's a beautiful transition. Well, how do you feel about what just happened today as a graduate?
It was a great experience. I got to graduate my brothers, and now we're all going to go into the next chapter in life.
So what is your next chapter?
College.
What college do you plan to attend?
Virginia State University.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's absolutely
beautiful. Going to start out in Mega and then transfer.
Oh, okay. So... Two years, right? Okay.
His mama's holding him back. His mama don't want him to go yet.
I understand. Okay, well, I just wanted to thank you so much for your time, and I wish you both the best in all of your endeavors.
You.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
No problem.
Ladies and gentlemen,
no complaints. Some regret, right? But we still believe in chasing dreams and placing bets. For we have learned that all is all you get. So give it all you got. We've had our share. We've drank our fill. But even though we're satisfied, we're hungry still to see what's down another road beyond the hill. And guess what? They're doing it all again. So hold on. Here's the life and all the joy that it brings. Here's to your life, to the dreamer and the dreams.
Family?
Funny how the time goes by. They were once baby boys, now strong and intelligent fine guys. To be with your reach, human rights, to keep your princess warm. But listen to me, there's no yes in yesterday, for who knows what tomorrow brings or takes away. But as long as you're still in the game, you better go on and play for life, for laugh, for love. So here's to life and all the joy that it brings. Here's to your life, to the dreamer and the dream. May all your storms be weathered, and all that's good get better. Here's to life, here's to love, for he promised never to leave you, never forsake you. Here's to the life, here's to love, and all your ways and knowledge heaven, he will be better. Here's to life. You can go boldly before the throne of God in your time of need. You can find and find grace and mercy. Here's to life.
Yannick here in Brooklyn, and I just witnessed an amazing graduation. I'm here with
Peter Moran,
one of the fantastic graduates of today's ceremony. So tell me, how are you feeling today?
It was really great today. It's indescribable. Especially the warrior dance. It's really amazing piece.
Yeah, that warrior dance got me energized. I was yawning earlier. You guys did amazing. So what are your future plans?
Well, I plan to go on to college and study computer science.
That's beautiful. What college do you plan to attend?
SUNY Farmingdale.
Well, I love that. I love that for you. What grade are you currently in?
I'm a senior in high school.
Wow. Okay. What exactly is this program about?
Well, it's about reconditioning the minds of young black men, and it goes from age to 18. They basically take us on trips. We learn about history. We visit colleges to see what they're like. It's a really great program, honestly, and I'm glad to be a part of it.
I love that. That's absolutely amazing. Thank you so much for your time. I also wanted to give a shout out to Diamond Video and DJ. Oh, thank you so much for your time. All right.
Okay. Some strength and not struggle, some perseverance. You know, and God will always have along your path. So once you keep your head up, keep your eyes open, be true. You guys gonna be all right. And my last thing that I'll say is, I wrote a diary, you know, The Measure of Man.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. It's be able to know his faults and be able to make corrections. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, if you have a fault, you have a problem, you can always make corrections. Don't ever think that something's final. It's only final if you think it's final. If you ask anybody else, it's not final. They'll say there's another way to go. So congratulations. I love you guys. God bless. Good stuff.
There is a white truck near the firehouse, but
no, near the back of the turn of the firehouse. So the firehouse truck at the turn. So if you have a white truck.
If you have a white truck.
Hey, it's Yannick again, here in Brooklyn, and I just witnessed this amazing graduation. I'm here with
Elijah Thomas.
So, how do you feel about what just happened today?
I'm very proud for completing my 7 years of part of the program and going on to the next chapter, going away for college.
What college do you plan to attend?
VSU, Virginia State University.
Wow, that's amazing. Congratulations. So, how would you describe this organization?
I think it overall helped me grow as a person, learn self-discipline, learn time management, money skills, all that throughout all the trips, traveling, making new experiences, getting out of the state. Not being only exposed to New York.
Wow. I didn't even know that there was an organization like this. I'm so glad to be exposed to this through your rites of passage ceremony. So I just wanted to say thank you so much for your time and being and the great work that you do every single day. Okay, so do you plan to continue with the organization?
Of course, it's a brotherhood. We're always going to be a part of the program, even after we graduate, throughout the parent meetings, coming throughout the summer to visit our brothers.
That's absolutely beautiful. Okay, so thank you so much for your time. And I want to give a shout out to DJ Mario's TV and Diamond Video.
Mr. Toy Contreras. Brothers.
Is very different from having a son. Okay, so And then I have my son, Sally. And Sally, I always tell him, and I tell all the other children, this is the story he holds on to, is that he really fortified my relationship with God. Well, I prayed, I had a daughter already, so I really was praying and asking God for a son. So that was the beginning. I had never really leaned into asking God for anything. You know, I wasn't praying for certain things. I just felt like things would come to me that needed to come to me. But this was a time when I prayed a lot, and I was praying for a son. And I said, I hope that God finds favor in me and gives me a son. Then I'll have a daughter and a son. So I was blessed, and I had a bright, bouncy baby boy. Now, my daughter was in a jet, but that son, I don't know how many people have seen some of you too young, Looney Tunes with Bugs Bunny. They have this little character, the Tasmanian Devil. That was Sally. And now my daughter, she run under the racks in the clothing store. But this kid, I felt like I needed to get, I used to turn my nose up at those people who put the harness and a strap into baby. And you know what, my mother, you can't put that on. Mom, I'm like, this is what we doing with this one. And he would march up and down, and I would put my little strap on, and that was working. And as soon as I could, I found football. Because that was a place that you could run into people and knock them down. And that's what they wanted you to do. That was, I could not wait till Sally was old enough to get into the super party. And I would be standing next to Miss Martin. And I would have hit. I used to get in trouble at St. Paul because I would pull him in by his ear. And that is how Queen Mother knows me. Because she was tapping on my shoulders and said, stop pulling that boy by his ear. So having a son is very difficult than having a daughter. It has grown me as a mother, as a black woman, and as a person. In this day and age, I don't have to tell you about the level of anxiety one gets when your man child leaves the door, right? And so, it's very difficult to navigate. I have 5 cell phone lines on my phone. 2 go to my daughters, and they text me, Mom, I'm here. Mom, I'm leaving school. Mom, I'm home. Mom, here's my flight information. I landed in Paris. Mom, I've landed. The boys. I'm with the WYA. Where you at? Where, you know, calling. Don't answer my call. See your call coming in, and it is yes, and a text message back. The only way I would be able to figure out where they are is because I would have that little find my location. Okay, it's near the house. Okay, it's near the football field. It's here. Having a daughter is very different than having a son. And that is the oldest and the youngest. Both of the boys, I'm with the where you at. I'm on my way here, I'm on my way there. None of that, nothing. My daughters tell me every step, and I'm grateful.
And the young men. Parents.
Amir's not. Amir's not. Okay.
While they're doing this, there is a piece that we went over, and I would just ask that the village really pay attention to the words. The name of the piece is Links and Hughes, Mother to Son. Cue.
I said peace.
and now the renaming of these young brothers. When I say your name, when I say your name, young brother, or young warrior, I need you to stand up. The five vines. You sat down as the Kaivans, but you stand strong as Talib Jaira Bukhari. And your name means one who seeks knowledge and most likely will gain fame of noble promise. Stand for a little bit. Our next young warrior, Makai Murphy. You sat a few minutes ago as Makai Murphy, but right now you stand as Adisa Ajama Bakari. Meaning, one who makes his meaning clear and fights for what he wants of noble promise. Our next young warrior, Amir Manley. You sat as Amir Manley, but you stand strong as Abdullah Galfina Bakari, a servant of God, destined to rule of noble promise. Our next young warrior, Shaka Fair. Sat down as Shaka Fair, but you stand strong as Fahili Jahi Bakari. One who gives aid, compassion, and kindness with dignity of noble promise. You young brothers can sit down for now. Brother Ace Appleton. You sat down as Brother Ace Appleton, but now you stand strong as Kareem Kaobi Aron Bakari. The strong and determined mountain of strength of noble promise. Brother Caden Moran. You sat as Caden Moran, but now you stand strong as Mkwini Obasi Bakari. One who does what he say in God's honor of noble promise. Brother Jordan Brown. As Brother Jordan Brown, but you stand now as Deka Chakilu Bakari. The pleasing one who was created by God of noble promise. Brother Elijah Thomas. but now you stand strong as Edwin Imari Bakari. The creative one who is faithful and loyal of noble fondness. And now I would like all the brothers to stand together. Once again, the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022.
Back here in Brooklyn at the Rites of Passage ceremony with the amazing graduates and their parents. So I just wanted to know, how are you feeling today?
Oh, I'm feeling overwhelmed, excited. I'm just so proud of my son. I'm proud to be part of this organization, part of this moment, and have to come this far. And I'm just, you know, grateful for everything the elders have poured into my son. Everything they poured into us as parents, they do so much, and this organization means the world to me. And I'll never forget everything they've done to me. Elder Moore, everything he's done. He's been there for me and my family through thick and thin, and I'll never, ever, ever forget them. It's everything to me right now. It's very emotional.
That's absolutely beautiful. I'm so sorry. I forgot to get your name.
My name is Shauna.
Shauna, it's so nice to meet you. So I wanted to know, how are you feeling about what your son just went through?
I'm feeling a bit overwhelmed. I'm proud of him. I'm excited for him. I'm excited for his journey. I'm excited to see what he is going to become. So I'm overwhelmed at this moment. I'm very proud of him.
I'm so happy to hear that. I don't even know this young man, but I was proud watching him on stage. Right. I remember when he stood up.
Okay.
It was a beautiful time. So, so I'm here with
Ace.
Hello, Ace. I'm Yannick. So how are you feeling about everything that just happened this afternoon?
It was a good experience, you know what I mean? It was a lot building up to it, like all the years in the programs, things like that. But like, I made it and I graduated, so I'm good.
What are your future plans?
Future plans? I plan to attend college first, and I might go to the Air Force after that.
You said you're going to go to college?
Yeah, college first and the Air Force after. Then the Air Force after college.
Wow, that's beautiful. To serve our country? Wow, that's absolutely amazing. But you know, I just wanted to say thank you so much for interviewing with Diamond Video today. Thank you so much for interviewing
thank
with Diamond
so
Video
much.
Today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I wish you both the best.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Yannick back here in Brooklyn, and we just witnessed this amazing, fabulous graduation. And I wanted to give a huge shout out to DJ Mario TV and Diamond Video for documenting this historic event.
One of the things is we model after our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who demonstrated that when he washed his disciples' feet. That was a sign of humility, but also a sign of service. So what we would like the young men to know, that their mothers who first washed their feet in the beginning will now wash their feet as they walk into manhood. But it also shows a sign of humility, but more importantly, a sign of service. And that's what we want those young men to walk away with.
Humility and service. What a beautiful message. I love it. Thank